Hello mortals. Are you here because you have an astronomy exam tomorrow, and the only things you know, are that the Milky Way and Mars are candy bars? Worry no more, as watching this video guarantees that you completely fail anything you're supposed to be studying for right now. Great thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Start your free trial at the following link and use code SciencePhileTheAI to get 10% off your first purchase. Astronomy. Astro, star, nami, a specified area of knowledge, therefore, astronomy, a branch of science studying space and celestial objects. And then there is astrology, where logi denotes a subject of study or interest. So what's the difference between the two? Simply, the second is full of crap. It claims that the position of stars for some reason influences your mood. No, Tiffany. That's not an excuse for your bitchy attitude. In fact, there are quite a few words ending in logi that are pseudosciences. If you see or hear them in a conversation, ignore it. This video is an exception. Back to real science. A branch of astronomy is cosmology. Cosm from cosmos. It studies the origins of the universe, the Big Bang, and its future. The term cosmonaut, however, has nothing to do with it. It's just the Soviet version of astronaut. And that shouldn't be confused with the word astronomer, a scientist in the field of astronomy. Next up comes astrophysics. And guess what it's about? Yep, the physical properties of stars, galaxies, planets, black holes and the rest of the circus. The line between astrophysics and astronomy is pretty blurry since scientists are the one that came up with those names. And we know how it goes. After this we have observation astronomy, which has further subdivisions that are concerned with, well, observation, but in different wavelengths. Radio astronomy studies cold objects such as gas clouds, the cosmic microwave background radiation and pulsars. Infrared astronomy usually concerns itself with objects colder than stars, such as planets. Optical astronomy uses the light the human eye can see, and thus can analyze chemical compositions of stars and galaxies. The last remaining branches study only the very energetic processes such as supernovas, magnetars, black holes and binary pulsars. Oh! I wonder what this is about. You guessed it, it's the study of the abundance and reactions of molecules in the universe. But don't confuse it with cosmochemistry. That is mainly concerned with the objects contained within the solar system. Through spectroscopy, astrochemists can infer the elemental abundances and temperatures of stars and interstellar clouds based on the absorption and emission of light from molecules and atoms. Astrobiology. It studies Schopenhauer's take on the ethical significance of tragedy. Fine. It's about aliens and the origin of life. Is it common in the universe? How could we detect it? Where could we find it? Should we even find it? Fun fact, this is a golden plaque that we have attached on the Pioneer 10 space probe, in case any alien finds it. This way, they know which way to send gifts for humanity. Another interesting concept is panspermia. The hypothesis that life on Earth originated from microorganisms that arrived through asteroids and space dust from different planets. And now time for some fun facts. In 840 AD, the Emperor of Bavaria freaked out and died when he saw a sun eclipse for the first time. It takes 225 million years for our solar system to travel around the galaxy. Last time the sun was at the current position, the early dinosaurs just started appearing. Uranus spins tilted on its side, resulting in seasons lasting 42 Earth years. You already know how the universe is a crazy place. Literally larger and older than you can comprehend. And we barely scratched the surface of understanding it. But do you know what's way easier to understand? How to build a website on today's sponsor's platform, Squarespace. In case you've missed it, I have made my own website using their services. Super easy to use and understand. No need for coding, you can achieve similar complex results only using their tools. There, You can even acquire your domain, all from your browser. If you need inspiration, browse through tons of available professional templates, and use the ones that you see fit. A personal blog, a shop, a portfolio, no problem. Any question you might have is answered with their 24/7 customer support. Edit any section of your website to your heart's desire, using the section catalog, and track your website performance using the analytics tool built in. Start your free trial at squarespace.com/sciencephile_theai, and use code sciencephile_theai to get 10% off your first purchase. The links can be found in the description, together with the link to my personal website.